And here is the Writer's Almanac for Thursday. It's the 26th of November, 2020. Thanksgiving Day, a holiday that goes back to 1621 and the Puritan colony in Plymouth, Massachusetts. It's the birthday of the novelist Marilyn Robinson, born Sandpoint, Idaho, 1943. Her first novel, 1980, Housekeeping, story of two sisters in a town called Fingerbone, Idaho. Their mother commits suicide. Their aunt moves back to town to take care of them. Marilyn Robinson went off to teach at the University of Kent in England. She learned about a nuclear facility dumping toxic waste into the Irish Sea, which resulted in unusually high rates of cancer among local children. She wrote a book about it called Mother Country. Came back to this country, University of Iowa, wrote her second novel, Gilead, in 2004. An epistolary novel, series of letters from a dying 76-year-old Congregationalist pastor in the town of Gilead, Iowa, in which Marilyn Robinson wrote, "Sometimes I have loved the peacefulness of an ordinary Sunday. It is like standing in a newly planted garden after a warm rain. All it needs from you is that you take care not to trample on it." And it's the birthday of the cartoonist Charles Schulz, born Minneapolis, 1922. His father was a barber, supported the family on 35-cent haircuts. Every Sunday, the boy and his father read the funny pages together. The boy hoped to become a cartoonist, but he had a rough time in school, felt picked on by teachers, other students. His cartoons were not even accepted by the high school yearbook. He was drafted into the army. His mother died of cancer a couple of days before he left home. When he came back, he moved in with his father in the apartment above the barbershop and started drawing a cartoon strip for the local paper called Little Folks. He fell in love with a red-haired woman. They dated for a while. He asked her to marry him. She turned him down and soon after married someone else. Schulz was bitter about it for the rest of his life. But in 1950, the first Peanuts cartoon strip appeared in national papers, introducing Charlie Brown, and then Snoopy, and then the rest over the years, Linus, Lucy, Schroeder, Pigpen, Peppermint Patty, and Charlie Brown's unrequited love, known simply as the Little Red-Haired Girl. Charles Schulz, who said, "My whole life has been one of rejection, women, dogs, comic strips." Here's a poem for today by Jane Hirschfield, entitled Cook. "Each night you come home with five continents on your hands, garlic, olive oil, saffron, anise, coriander, tea, your fingernails blacken with marjoram and thyme. Sometimes the zucchini's flesh seems like a fish steak cut into neat fillets, or the salt-rubbed eggplant yields not bitter water, but dark mystery. You cut everything to bits. No core, no kernel, no seed is sacred. You cut onions for hours and do not cry. Cut them to thin transparencies, the red ones spreading before you like fallen flowers. You cut scallions from white to green. You cut radishes, apples, broccoli. You cut oranges, watercress, romaine. You cut your fingers. You cut and cut beyond the heart of things where nothing remains. And you cut that too, scoring coup on the butcher block, leaving your mark. When you go, your feet are as pounded as brioche dough." A poem by Jan Hirschfield, Cook, from Of Gravity and Angels, published by Wesleyan University Press and used by permission here in the Writer's Almanac, funded by donations from listeners like you, now available on PRX for distribution by your local radio station. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.